Hey, what's up, Stock Compounders? Brad here. So the topic today might seem like it has nothing to do with investing at first glance, but it actually has a lot to do with investing. Okay, and here's why. Compound growth. What is compounding? Okay, there's really three factors that go into compounding wealth. Okay, the first one is how much capital you plow into the compound growth engine. All right, how much you contribute. The second is rate of return. How skillful are you at deploying that capital into businesses that return that capital and more? And the last one, perhaps the most important one, is the length of the runway, okay? How much time you compound. So today we're gonna get into that last one, how to potentially extend the length of your runway, which has massive impact on your portfolio. So there's kind of two sources that inspired this deep dive into kind of longevity and biohacking. The first one is the All In podcast, which is, you know, a weekly podcast I've been really diving into, really getting excited about this podcast. There's a lot of great information in these weekly episodes. And episode 26, which came out on March 19th, gets into longevity and biohacking, okay? And in this podcast, David Friedberg, who you can see here, mentions a book called Lifespan by David Sinclair. So I downloaded it on Audible and took a listen. It's fantastic. And one thing I really appreciate at the end of the book, you know, it's a very science, it's a book, basically, what is the science of aging, okay? But at the end, David Sinclair shares what he does for his own longevity with a bunch of caveats, of course. It's probably not all that common for a scientist to share something so practical in terms of, you know, what they do based on what they're studying, the science behind it. So I'm going to share what David Sinclair does to extend his lifespan. So let's get into some notes that I took on both the All In podcast and this book, Lifespan. So in the All In podcast, David Friedberg basically says aging is a disease. Okay, it's not necessarily an inevitable process. It's a disease. And like I said, the book Lifespan goes into research on improving healthy longevity. Okay, this isn't just extending the lifespan at any cost. You know, nobody wants to be in a debilitated state just so that they can live longer. This is about living longer and healthy, being healthy throughout that lengthened lifespan. So it was discovered through science, there's an early switch that evolved in evolutionary biology. So our cells, the cells that make us up as humans, are either in growth mode or they're in repair mode. And the key is, can you get the gene to switch on that puts the cell into repair mode, okay? The cell is in repair mode, that's going to cause the organism to live longer. Because the cell, it fixes itself. And because of that, it lives longer. A number of genes trigger this repair mechanism in the cells. And a number of compounds appear to trigger the expression of those genes that flip on the repair mechanisms. So there's compounds and there's, you know, things that we can do in our lives, not just consume, but ways that we can behave. So what are these ways? In terms of lifestyle, fasting, okay? It's something I've been doing recently, intermittent fasting. So I eat in an 8-hour window, and then for 16 hours, I'm giving my body, you know, a chance to not be dealing with breaking down food. So there's potentially some repair, restorative mechanisms associated with that, 16-hour break from digestion. Exercise, high-intensity interval training comes up again and again as a way to kind of keep us healthy. And then there's kind of research coming out about cold treatment. And, you know, Wim Hof is big into this, but like ice baths, there's these kind of cryogenic chambers that you can get into, and it's very cold air that your body is exposed to for a short period of time. And supposedly that stress activates these repair mechanisms in our bodies. And of course, there's compounds that also mimic this kind of what fasting would do on a cellular level. So metformin is one of these substances, rapamycin, NAD supplements, NMN, NR. We're going to get into NMN towards the end here. But the process of aging is a biological process that we can theoretically stop and even reverse, okay? So that's a massive shift for a lot of people, this idea that we're not necessarily destined to age and die. It's a big time shift. And it's not necessarily something that I fully prescribe to at this point, but it has my curiosity. So I'm diving deeper into it. David Friedberg on the All In podcast said, arguably someone alive on Earth today could live past the age of 200 years old. And author David Sinclair of the book Lifespan wants to live to see 2100. Okay, that would make him 131 years old. He's not sure that that's even feasible, but that's, he's hoping that he'll be able to do that, to live that long. So that's it from the All In podcast. Let's jump to Lifespan and what David Sinclair does to try to extend his healthy lifespan. What I do. So every morning, 1 gram or 1,000 milligrams of NMN and 1,000 milligrams of resveratrol mixed into some homemade yogurt, okay? So gram NMN, a gram of resveratrol. And here's what NMN is. Nicotinamide mononucleotide, all right? That's what NMN is. And then 1 gram of metformin, which I believe is primarily a diabetes medication. Helps control insulin in the body. So those are the three kind of supplements, NMN, resveratrol, metformin, and then a daily dose of vitamin D, vitamin K12, and 83 milligrams of aspirin. So that's kind of the supplements that David Sinclair takes every day. Now, some tips for extending healthy lifespan. He strives to keep sugar, bread, and pasta intake as low as possible. Those are things that spike insulin. He gave up desserts at the age of 40. Granted, he still sneaks a bite every now and then, but he doesn't have full-on desserts anymore for the last 12 years. Which is pretty impressive. That's going to be difficult for a lot of us to give up, I'm sure. He tries to skip one meal per day. It's usually lunch because he tends to be very busy throughout the workday in his research lab, so it's easiest for him to just skip lunch. I skip breakfast. I start eating at lunch, and then I have dinner, and then I'm done. Every few months, he gets a blood draw to analyze for a dozen biomarkers. And, you know, those results tell him what he might need to tweak in terms of his food and exercise to hit optimal levels with those biomarkers. He tries to take a lot of steps each day and walk upstairs, right? If there's a choice between stairs and an elevator, he'll take the stairs. Goes to the gym most weekends with his son, lifts weights, jogs, and then he'll hang out in the sauna before dunking into an ice cold pool. Okay, so kind of the hot cold treatment. I'm just, you know, kind of as an aside, I'm Finnish, so I have a long history in my genetics of saunas. I should really get a sauna, and it'd be fun to pair that with like a cold plunge. Eats a lot of plants and tries to avoid eating other mammals. So kind of a high vegetable, low meat diet. He does eat meat after working out, to have that those proteins to kind of build that muscle. Avoids smoking, doesn't smoke. Avoids microwaving in plastic, okay? Avoids excessive UV exposure, x-rays, CT scans. Tries to stay on the cool side during the day and when he sleeps at night. This is, again, the research coming out about kind of cold treatment, cold plunges. It's funny, I have an uncle who lives in Texas, and every winter, granted it doesn't get super cold in Dallas, but every winter, he'll wear a t-shirt and he'll go for a walk to get that cold exposure, which kind of revs up, you know, the body's response to that cold exposure. And he thinks it helps him burn fat, which is interesting. Aims to keep weight/BMI in optimal range for health span, which is, according to David Sinclair, male in the U.S. around age 52, somewhere in the 23 to 25 BMI range. And then lastly, supplements. So supplements aren't very well regulated in the U.S. So you got to kind of do some of your own research on, you know, reputable supplements. You want a high quality supplement. If you're going to take NMN or resveratrol or a host of other things. So tips from David Sinclair on supplements. Look for a large manufacturer with a good reputation. Seek highly pure molecules, more than 98%. And look for GMP on the label, which stands for good manufacturing practices. So I haven't bought NMN before, but I just wanted to pull up this example for you guys. So you see here GMP right on the label, good manufacturing practices. You see here certified 99% pure powder, okay? So that exceeds the 98% threshold recommended by David Sinclair. I'm going to talk to my doctor first about some of these treatments, like the supplements, NMN, resveratrol. What was the other one David takes? Metformin. I'm going to talk to my doctor about those things, see if it makes sense for me. But I'm excited. I'm excited to really plunge into this arena of life extension in a healthy way, right? Not sacrificing quality of life just to eke out some more years. So anyway, guys, I thought this was interesting enough to share on this investing channel. Because, you know, like I said, it's the number one, I would say, way to get to that wealth point in your life for financial freedom. To amass a lot of wealth is to invest for the longest time possible. You know, Warren Buffett started at 11 years old. And what, I think he 89 or 90 right now? That's, you know, almost 80 years of compounding, okay? And even if you're starting it in your 30s or in your 40s, if we can really tap in to the latest science on how to live healthier and longer, that's gonna help the portfolio, as silly as it sounds. It's huge. It's huge for compounding. So just wanted to share some of this latest research on lifespan and longevity. Let me know what you guys are doing to, you know, extend your runway, and any other research that I should take a look at that you guys have come across. So anyway, thank you all for being here once again, as always, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.